And now it is time for the news, read tonight by Kaz Stevens, who also wrote it. Good evening. Queen Elizabeth, that is UK Queen Elizabeth, has adopted a new Christmas role play. She is now taking on the role of Scrooge and has been dubbed Queen Scrooge as a result. Claiming that there is a need to cancel her annual staff Christmas party in line with difficult circumstances facing the country, quote, the Queen has prompted the question of, is one a Scrooge? Normally, the lavish annual Christmas party paid for by Queen Scrooge and costing some £50,000 is laid on to show her staff some appreciation for the services. But this year, Queen Scrooge has cancelled the bash and insists that every member of staff shall be dished up a bowl of gruel instead and a mug of tap water decanted directly from the palace kitchen taps. There will be no presents, even for Tiny Tim Lawrence, Queen Scrooge's son-in-law, despite protests from Princess Anne, who is married to Tiny Tim Lawrence. He, like Princess Anne herself, will have to make do with some free horse manure served up in the stables at the palace for the somewhat equestrian couple. Prince Charles will not get a pair of new joke shop ears this year, unlike in previous years where Queen Scrooge has made a special pilgrimage to Blackpool in Lancashire in order to buy some for him on Blackpool Promenade. Queen Scrooge has announced that the Duchess of Cornwall will get no Cornish pasties this year, but she is thought to be somewhat surprised by this announcement since she is not normally given anything anyway. It is a known fact that Queen Scrooge dislikes her, and it shows. Prince Andrew and his family will get no Weight Watchers TV dinners this year, despite being regarded by the Queen, or by Queen Scrooge, as cheap, like his former wife Sarah Ferguson, but money of course is tight in the royal household this year. Prince Edward and wife Sophie Wessex and their children will be given no more pink ballet shoes and leotards as in previous years, despite the fact that they like to enjoy a more gay and flamboyant Christmas, to include cross-dressing and performing drag queen acts at local theatres. Edward likes to dress up in Sophie's clothes, and it is rumoured that he is rather gay. While Sophie is believed to be a man in drag and apparently enjoys dressing up in Edward's clothing. Prince William will get a new toy helicopter to play with this year, given that he is the Queen Scrooge's favourite grandson, but Queen Scrooge will be unable to buy him another real one this year, so he will have to be grateful for a toy one instead. Prince Harry will not be getting a packet of cigarettes and a pint of beer in his favourite local, the Jet Set Yob, so he will not be able to drown any of his sorrows this Christmas as he normally does. Prince Philip will not be getting tartan boxer shorts this year, but he will be getting a volume of his favourite book, How to Make Another Verbal Blunder in One Easy Lesson. The book has a nice tartan cover and bears a photograph of Prince Philip on the front. Queen Scrooge denies favouritism despite accusations to the contrary. However, Queen Scrooge is treating herself to a new frock from her favourite outfitters, Oxfam, this year. She has a gift voucher towards the cost of this from Prince Philip and the kids, so it will mean only having to pay half price for her new frock, which would set her back nothing more than £700,000, a huge saving in these difficult circumstances facing the country, insists Queen Scrooge. There will be no 3 p.m. Christmas broadcast by Queen Scrooge this year, as she wants to save money on that also. So she has asked the media to broadcast a message to the nation on her behalf, saying, please donate to the poverty-stricken royals this year, as they have been refused a poverty grant and are shivering around the cat, who is now employed in sucking peppermints to keep them all warm. The media have deemed Queen Scrooge a tad senile and have made no promises to make the demented broadcast on her behalf. Meanwhile, conservationists have been summoned to the palace by Prince Charles to see how his parents' home can be made more green and efficient in a bid to save the taxpayer more money. It is thought that Prince Charles is trying to win the favour of David Cameron in case he refuses him a poverty grant too. Conservationists have now found new uses for Queen Scrooge's many bucket-style hats. They are now being used as plant pots for growing herbs in, which will save on the culinary herb bill for the palace. Banana trees have been planted in the palace corridors so that monkeys can swing from tree to tree with messages and memos between the Queen, Scrooge, and her staff, which means that the servants who once fulfil this task will be made redundant. The palace monkeys, headed by Wacko Jacko, have been specially trained by Prince Charles to only eat a specified ration of bananas each day so that Queen Scrooge and Prince Philip can live on the rest. The new jungle telegraph will be cheaper to operate than the former one, which employed humans. No more lavish dinner parties will be held at the palace, so spare dining chairs will be used for firewood, making better use of in-house natural fuel resources. Cling film will replace the proposed double glazing planned previously for the palace. This will be installed next week and hopefully reduce a carbon footprint or two. Herds of cattle will be brought up from the Duchy of Cornwall estate to provide milk and meat for the palace, homegrown to save on present transportation costs between Cornwall and London. However, Queen Scrooge is said to be unhappy at the prospect of walking in cowpat and being mooed at as she walks the corgis in the palace grounds. Just some of the proposed changes at Buckingham Palace this year. Prince Charles and Camilla are thought to be unhappy about ascending to the throne should Queen Scrooge abdicate, as they are not keen on the new proposed royal title of King and Queen Scrooge of England and Wales to boot. Prince Charles is said to be considering passing up the royal position and just retiring on a state pension to a small rented cottage in Wales where lots of English people come home to real fires. It is not known who will take on the new title or role, or whether the palace will instead become just a workhouse for the poor, headed by Mr. Oliver Twist-Cratchett. We shall, of course, keep you updated on this story. More news later. Watch this space, minus the ghosts of Christmas present, past and future.